Good morning, Jai Jinendra. I'm Mayuri Zaveri, Board of Trustee of Jain Temple of Metropolitan Chicago. From Jain Temple to my home to your home, we are celebrating. Today, 8th day of Dasht Lakshana Parva. We have well-known Samaniji from Florida, USA, and last time I already gave you some information about her. She is from Florida, but she was born in a Kutch, Gujarat, India, 1985, and she did double master, associate, master of art in English and master of art in Agams. She knows quite a few languages like English, Prakrit, Sanskrit, Rajasthani, Hindi. Her specialization is a Jain Agam Preksha Meditation and Sanskrit Prakrit Grammar. We want to say that her subject is today is a meditation. And sometimes we all wonder, is it looking through our eyes? Is it closing eyes? Is it listening the music? Is it chanting the same words or sentences? Is it not to think anything and stay quiet? That's what meditation is? Question is, we are not sure what is exactly meditation is. We are gonna learn from many different experts. And let's start from today. We are going to learn meditation from respected Samaniji Santi Pragyaji. We are going to bring many different people to show us that different techniques to do meditation. One day we will also learn how to Lord Mahavira did his sadhana and meditation, and we will reach to our own conclusion. Let's welcome respected Samaniji Santi Pragyaji. Vandami Namam Sami.
Thank you. Mayuri Ben.
Jai Jine. Pranam.
Om Rim Namo Adihantanam. Om Rim Namo Siddhanam. Om Rim Namo Ayariyanam. Om Rim Namo Vachayanam. Om Rim Namo Loi Sabba Sahunam. Om Rim Namo Arehantanam. Om Rim Namo Siddhanam. Om Rim Namo Ayariyanam. Om Rim Namo आराध्य देव के चरणों में वंदन, परम पूज्य गुरुदेव के चरणों में वंदन। डियर्स ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, मेडिटेशन टुडेज सेशन इज मेडिटेशन। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू आस्क यू, व्हाट इज मेडिटेशन? What is your viewpoint of? According to you, what is meditation? What do you think about meditation? Any of you, you can share your views. What is meditation? Yeah. No.
Samniji, they want to learn from you.
Yeah, but I also want to learn from them that they what they believe.
I see.
What are their views?
Nina or Jill, somebody please say something. I don't think Samniji they are hearing maybe.
Okay. So okay, what is meditation according to you, Mayuri Ben?
Meditation is more like you just try to reach your own self and let go the worldly life around you and get the peace and happiness.
So generally, we realize some people doing meditation for peace, some for health, some for to be awaken their own selves or to know their soul. So, what is meditation? Depend. That's what you want by that. So. Why meditate? When we answer this question, then that according to that why are you meditating? According to that, the answer of the definition of meditation will be changed. It can be changed. And meditation is very powerful. Today, I mean, doctors, specialists, general practitioners. I have agreed that meditation is a powerful complementary therapy. Meditation can help us in healing and sustenance of good health. It can also cure and even protect us from several psychosomatic disorders that result from mental stress and tension. So meditation is very important, and you can say that today's life. In today's life, too much necessary. It's very important to do meditation. There are so many meditation therapies, and we can say that meditation is a key to spiritual treasure trove. And there are so many meditation therapies out there, but I want to introduce today Plexa meditation. Plexa meditation is not just for achieving physical, mental, or emotional well-being, but it is a key to spiritual trajectory. And Plexa meditation is a technique of meditation that aims bringing about positive attitudinal and behavioral changes through overall transformation in personality. Thank you. So this Praksha meditation, this is a technique which is derived from the wisdom of our ancient philosophy, Jain scriptures. How Lord Mahavira did meditation, how Lord Rakshisha on that time, Bahubali and the Chakravarti, how they did meditation and they attained Keval Dhyan. So it is authentic based. It is also from ancient wisdom of our ancient philosophy, our Jain scriptures. But it is also authentically based on the current scientific principles. So the main purpose of Praksha meditation is to purify the mental state. The human mind is constantly exposed to contaminating urges, emotions and passions. Therefore, it is essential to remove these obstacles. Peace of mind appears with the disappearance of the impure thoughts. In addition, we can say balanced mind, equanimity and well-being are also experienced simultaneously. Uncontrolled emotions like anger, greed, etc. are not only the hurdles in our future progress, but they are also become the cause of disaster in our social life. So we can understand it through an illustration. Once a gentleman bought a new car. The family felt extremely happy with the position. In the evening, the son was playing with his friends and unknowingly hit the car with a sharp stone. The father got furious when he saw the damaged car. In spite of anger, he hit his son with the iron rod he was holding. The child's hand started bleeding profusely and became unconscious because of the unbearable pain. Immediately, his father rushed to the hospital and the child was operated upon. After a while, when the child regained consciousness, he apologized to his father. He said, "Sorry, Dad, I hit and damaged your new beautiful car. I'll never do it again." Hearing his little son's words, tears rolled down the father's cheek. He was speechless. Suddenly, the little boy felt that he has no fingers in his hand. And he asked his father innocently, "Dad, Bambi, I have my fingers big." The father went blank. He did not have the courage to face his son. Can you imagine the agony of the innocent child and the regret of a father who disabled his own son's life for a bit card? How many times all of us fell into similar situations every day and react under uncontrolled anger or ego and have to regret later? When ever understood why it happens, the scientific explanation to the problem can be found in the fact that human beings possess two different parts of brain. You can say your right brain and left brain. No, I'm not talking about right and left brain. I'm talking about animal brain and human brain here. One is known as animal brain. which is responsible for our fundamental animal like instincts, and the other called the rational or logical brain that imparts us much finer human qualities. However, whenever we are overpossessed and controlled by the first brain, we lose control over our logical powers and fall into situations, as I illustrated. So under such situations, this Preksha meditation can help us regain, sustain and establish dominance of the logical brain over the animal brain. We are showered with excellent mental and spiritual teachings that can also help us transform our lifestyle. But in majority of cases, what happens? These teachings and our thought process, dominated by our lifestyle, go parallel. They are going parallel. Generally, they are going very parallel. They are not meeting each other. So we should ask ourselves that our spiritual teachings and our excellent mental teachings are going parallel or they are meeting each other. So as a result, what happens? Because they are going parallel, they are not meeting each other. Majority of us fall prey to circumstances very easily. For instance, a person can make a resolution not to tell lie, but a difficult situation may change him very easily and compel him to behave differently. The kind of temporary transformation happens because we often fail to register the reservation into the subconscious mind, and it remains at the level of our conscious mind. So what we need? We need to try to raise our unconscious mind, subconscious. Unless and until a resolution gets consolidated into our unconscious mind, we cannot experience the bliss of permanent transformation. Through the practice of Preksha meditation, we try to reach our unconscious mind, facilitate our reservation, and experience the permanent transformation of our personality. So there are so many components. So first of all, why you are doing meditation? I also asked in starting, but maybe you are don't want to share your views, but discover yourself, your purpose of doing meditation, whatever it is. When we learn Preksha meditation, the purpose of Preksha meditation is nirja, means self purification, and ashram nirodh. It means somewhere to stop the inflow of karma. We want to stop attracting karma. So this is the main purpose of Preksha meditation, and it was a purpose. The same purpose was for all Tirthankaras and all our favorite Jnanis. They did meditation with the same purpose. So this is the main purpose of Preksha meditation. But some relevant objectives are also there. When we do with the purpose of nidra and samvara, but with that we also get change in nature. We can feel that our nature is changing. We can control our anger, ego, greed, lust, anything we have. We can control it. Then mental peace. Yesterday only we had a meditation session on the afternoon. And at the afternoon. And the lady, first time he attended that meditation session, when he after that meditation, she shared her experience that when I started this meditation, I had a severe headache. I did many things for this, like I used oil and also, but it was that. But after completing this meditation session, I am feeling that there was no headache here. There is no headache I have. I am feeling very different. So mental peace also we can get from this meditation, and also good health. Also we can obtain our psychic knowledge. We can attain psychic knowledge. We can get intuition power. But these are the relevant objectives are there. The main purpose should be nidra and samvar. So basic components of practice meditation are so many. So they like sounds are there also. Kayal says antaryatra. Kayal says it means relaxation. Antaryatra, internal retreat. Swas preksha, perception of breathing. And sarir preksha, perception of physical body. Chaitanya kendra preksha, perception of psychic centers. Nishyadhan, perception of psychic colors. Anupeksha, contemplation, and chanting of mantras. But today we'll not discuss all these things. Today we'll which meditation we'll go to do. Today we'll do contemplation and meditation. So in that, first we'll do Mahapranadhvani. So Mahapranadhvani is a dhvani, it means sound. And sound is a very powerful and mystic medium of expression of certain to the goals. Some sounds have power in a single continuous vibration, while others are grouped notes that make a spiritual world. So Mahapranadhvani is a kind of sound produced before entering the stage of meditation. This sound vibrations transmit immense energy. And it can help us, the sound can help us in our intellectual development. And with the sound waves and the vibrations created during this pronunciation of Mahapranadhvani, it penetrates and circulates through our brain and activates our neurons. And it also helps us in reducing the unsteadiness of our thoughts. And in addition, I can say that it enhances the concentration of our mind. So a sustained practice leads to enhancement of the vital energy that helps sharpen our memory. And it also increases the lifespan of nervous neurons and regulates the secretion from the endocrine glands. So the vibrations of Mahapranadhvani smoothens the flow of blood in tissues and organs. So, what happens when we pull the Mahapranadhvani? So from the vocal cord, when the humming sound is, so Mahapranadhvani is a humming sound. So when the humming sound starts the journey, normally this sound waves travels out from mouth, but in this process we keep our lips closed. Hence the sound travels through inner cavity and spread like the fountain and vibrates the neurons. And because of this, what happens when it vibrates the neurons? But such a message to neurons make the passive neurons active and opens up the abundant space for memory to retain the truth for too prolonged time. So it's very, very beneficial, this Mahaprabhani. And when we do that with meditation, so first I want to say that how we'll do. So when we'll do Mahaprabhani, first what will we do? Exhale fully and then inhale slowly through the nostrils. Then what you have to do? You have to concentrate on your vocal cord, and while exhaling, you have to produce a sound like a buzzing bee with your vocal cord. The sound will be nasal sound. Vocal cord and nasal, both will be together. So when the humming sound becomes slow and subtle, we have to remain silent for a while, and then we should feel the sound inside our brain. So once we can do now, take deep breath. Meditation. Then second step in meditation, we'll do relaxation, kalsa. It means relaxation. Relaxation of body with full awareness. There's a difference, a little difference between only relaxation what today's we are saying, but in this in perspective of Jainism, is kalsa is a relaxation of body with full awareness. And according to Mahavir, Lord Mahavir, relaxation relieves one from all sorrow. So modern era has also termed this kalsa as relaxation as a school. And it is a process of awakening the consciousness and relieving oneself from stresses. So the first step of practice meditation, the sound is the entrance of that meditation, but then after that, the first step of practice meditation is relaxation, through which the stability of body is achieved. And in this practice, the muscles are relieved from stress and relaxed by other situation. So this practice of relaxation also constitutes the founder for anupeksha and meditation. Anupeksha, that is contemplation. So these are two important way of bringing about a change in our life. So unless one practice kalsa along with the exercise of anupeksha and meditation, one doesn't prove to be effective. So why we do relaxation? To realize that when we do relaxation, this kalsa, when we follow, so what we'll feel, what we will feel. So in starting the first stage of relaxation, when we enter in first stage, we'll feel that stability of body. We'll feel our stability of body. In second stage, we'll feel relief from all kinds of tensions. In the third stage, we'll feel abounding the gross body and coming closer to the subtle body. And in the fourth stage, the main purpose of this relaxation is realizing the detachment of soul from the body. Realizing that the soul and the body are two different entities. So this is the main purpose of kalsa. And the last stage of kalsa. So when we can do this when we do only kalsa. So 45 minutes for kalsa. But when we do it with any other contemplation or meditation, generally we do it for 2 to 5 minutes only. So when you do only kalsa, you can do it in a standing posture, sitting posture, or lying down. It's according to your wish. We can say that if a person learns and practices karasana and perform the exercise at least for half an hour every day, he will remain free from tension under all circumstances. It says that if a person is doing karasana for half an hour, he can get energy, he can regain energy of 3 hours sleep. It means when a person is taking sleep for 3 hours, after that, how much energy he will regain, that much energy will regain within 30 minutes of karasana relaxation. So, if half an hour we do every day, then we can remain free from tensions, and it will help us to get into the depth of our consciousness. Next, we'll follow the perception of breathing, swas preksha. So the swas preksha, when we are perception of breathing, is very beneficial for our meditation and our health also. We can say that the breath acts as a bridge between the body and the consciousness. That is a element, that type of element of the body that keeps it active and running. And a person may survive without food and water. We know that a person may survive without food and water for days, but not without air, right? Many in these days, many people have done maybe a 3 or 10 days fasting or more. But without air, we can't live. We not need air. So therefore, it is essential for all of us to learn and practice the correct way of breathing, the vital force of life. So when we practice in the right way, breathing forces, then what will happen? That we'll be free from attachment and aversion. Will improve concentration and alertness, and also overcome negative emotions. Will live in the present moment, but it needs daily practice. Without practice, we can't achieve. And generally, how many breaths are you taking within a minute? Can you count? I will say start, and if you can't want to speak, it's okay. You can just. I think chat is enabled. May I repeat?
Yeah, chat is enabled.
Mm-hmm. So just you share in chat that how many. Okay, start. Count your breaths. Okay, stop. And how many breath, count. If you have counted 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, can you share?
6.
Yeah. If you want to speak, you can speak or share in chat. No? No one has done? Or no one is listening?
12.
12. Okay. And?
I think people are not counting. Some, kisini right, somebody says 10.
10.
Somebody says 15.
Yeah. How many? Maribel, you?
12.
12. Okay. 13. Okay. Okay, now again we'll do once more. When I say inhale, you have to take breath. Then when I say exhale, you have to take exhale. In and out, okay? Okay. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Okay. Any of you have any problem with this? Have you felt any problem?
No.
No.
It was very good actually.
No. It was very relaxing.
It was very relaxing. And how many breath have you taken?
8.
6 only.
6.
Only 6. 5 seconds inhaling and 5 seconds exhaling. Mm-hmm. So 10 seconds per breath. Right? So by practice we can improve our length of our breath. Breathing, okay? So it's also very good when we do this first pariksha, long breathing, by that we get more oxygen. And by that what will happen? Because generally what happens, majority of us don't breathe to full the capacity of our lungs. And incomplete breathing leads to insufficient supply of oxygen to our brain, and metabolism cells, and it also affects, after that what happens, that it affects in return, it will affect our working efficiency of our body. And in contrast, when we do long breathing, it makes the body energized. So if we do daily 10 to 15 minutes long breathing, if you get time, 10 to 15 minutes together. Otherwise, you can do in a full day, 2 minutes, 2 minutes in a part. So it is very useful. And then last, well, we'll do contemplation. And we'll do contemplation of forgiveness. Because contemplation is also useful. Forgiveness, we can say forgiveness or friendliness. Friendliness, forgiveness, amity, all these things are the same process for that. So, Raksa meditation also focuses on the perception, that is, perceive without attachment and aversion. Excluding, excluding thoughts of the past or imaginations of the future. So, during Preksha, one acknowledges the truth. But after we perceive and realize the truth, we need to contemplate in it in Anupreksha. When we contemplate, we can change ourselves, we can change our emotions, we can change our habits. So, in Dhyan Sata, it is stated that at the end of each meditation session, contemplation must be performed. And after meditation, four contemplations are generally practiced. First is contemplation of solitariness, second transitoriness, third is contemplation of tolerance, and fourth is contemplation of amity or friendliness or forgiveness. That's same thing. So these are the main thing. So today we'll do meditation, and at last we'll do contemplation of forgiveness. And by this contemplation, we can feel that we are benefiting by physical, psychological, emotional, and spiritual benefits. Like we are benefiting by all these ways. In fact, we can say that contemplation can be practiced to change deep-rooted habits, addictions, including drinking, smoking, stealing, and lying. Every year, in India, in international Preksha meditation camps, hundreds of people come, and many people from Japan or Russia. They even don't know Hindi or English, but they are coming and they are feeling that by Preksha meditation, they change their life. They are feeling very well. So it's very, very powerful meditation technique, which is from our Jain agmas. So contemplation is also any reverse determination that we communicate to our subconscious mind and prove very effective under such conditions or situations, and we want to change ourselves. So I think now, are you ready to do meditation?
Ramaniji.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So, we ready?
Yes.
Sit straight. I think you all know now Mahaprandhani humming the song, right? No need. Once more, I demonstrate. There's no need, right? So we'll start. Close your eyes. We'll start the practice of contemplation with the recitation of Mahaprandhani. So please close your eyes softly, with your spine and neck straight, line. Exhale fully and then inhale deeply as long as you can. Exhaling slowly, produce the sound through the nostril like the buzzing of a bee. Mm-hmm. Try to feel the vibrations taking place inside your head and repeat this sound 5 times. Try to feel the vibrations which are taking place inside your head. Next step of meditation, kayotsal, relaxation. Give up your body. Let your body become limp. Focus your mind on the big toe of your right foot. Spread your concentration from your big toe up to the top of the head throughout your body. Suggest to your mind that it relaxes. Relax. From your toes up to the top of the head, each and every muscle and nerve is being relaxed. Relax. Practice total relaxation with self-awareness.
breath has become quiet and calm. This complete peace of mind, inner silence. Your body and mind have become free from all kinds of stress and tension. Feel yourself inside the body, but different from the body. Now, focus your attention on the center of vital energy, the bridge of the nose. Feel the touch of your breath. Experience the speed of your breath and subtle vibrations of your breath. Practice deep and slow and rhythmic breathing. Your breathing should be deep, slow, and rhythmic. Experience each and every breath in and out. Now, with a long inhalation, produce the particles of friendliness inside you. Produce the particles of friendliness inside you. Now suggest to yourself that I wish for my own progress, for my own auspiciousness, as well as for my own well-being. I wish my right knowledge to be increased, my intuition to be awakened, my serenity to be developed, and my body to be healthy. Once more, suggest to yourself that I wish for my own progress, for my own auspiciousness, as well as for my own well-being. I wish my right knowledge to be increased, my intuition to be awakened, my serenity to be developed, and my body to be healthy. By exhaling, now when you exhale, while exhaling, spread the particles of friendliness everywhere around you and fill your aura with these particles of love. Feel that the particles of love and friendliness are everywhere around you and inside you. The air passing through your body will make others happy and cheerful. Feel that the air passing through your body will make others happy and cheerful. Now, inhale deeply, and while exhaling, extend your mind throughout the world, or visualize a globe and bring it in front of you. Suggest to yourself that everyone, everybody in this world is my friend. Everybody in this world is my friend. I have friendliness with all. I wish for everybody's progress, auspiciousness, and well-being. Spread the particles of your love in all directions, north, south, east, west, up and down. extend the particles of love and friendliness and enjoy the friendliness with everybody. Experience pure love. Now, pass your best wishes to those people who live around you, your family, your friends, your colleagues, who are living around you. Pass your best wishes to those people. Contemplate that. You are all my friends. I have true friendship with you all. I wish for your progress, auspiciousness, and well-being. I wish your knowledge to be increased and that you may experience serenity and inner bliss. I wish that you achieve the pleasure of friendliness. Now, pass your best wishes to those people towards whom you have bad feelings, hatred. Visualize those people for whom you have negative feelings. Make the image clear. Bring it close to you. And say to that image, on this auspicious day, I am asking for forgiveness. I am forgiving you. Please forgive me. From today, you and me are best friends. We have true friendship, param maitri. I request you to come close me. Please, I am requesting you to come close to me. We'll build a new relation, a healthy relation. You are my friend, true friend. I wish for your progress, auspiciousness, and well-being. From today, we are best friends. We have true friendship, where there is no attachment, no aversion, only true friendship. Param Maitri is there. Feel the particles of friendliness in and out. take 2 or 3 deep breath, deep and long breath. Conclude the meditation. Yep, rub your palms. Keep it in your eyes. Softly, you can open your eyes. Okay, thank you.
Wow, Samniji, excellent.
Thank you. Want to ask anything about meditation or any, like this is the friendliness, contemplation of friendliness, and I experienced myself that because of that, this, we can change many things. Because we have pure emotions towards all living beings. And by that, we are also being positive, and it also affects our health. So you can follow this view. Okay? And if you have any questions, you can ask.
Samniji, there is one question coming.
Yeah.
Okay, what time is a good time to do the meditation?
What time is the best time? So I want to say that that time is the best time, a good time for the meditation, at which time you feel that I'm relaxed, I have no burden of anything else, and I can concentrate myself. For some people it can be early morning, for some people it can be afternoon, and for some it can be evening or late night also. So it depends on you that when you feel that I am okay with this time, I have no burden, no other thoughts, I am promise, I am from my wish, I want to do meditation at this time. Yeah. Anything else?
This is a new experience. Very nice.
Yeah, generally, in 8 days of pollution, we used to do this meditation. And we also met people to do this meditation. And people gave us share their experiences that even they never thought about that what sanskaras in our brain, all the from childhood they also reminder that yeah, I had been done this wrong with that person, now I should say sorry, I should forgive them, or I should also ask forgiveness.
It is, we are very happy that you taught us today. Excellent, excellent. And people who missed it, they really missed it. But that's okay. Maybe we will do again someday. And we really